Students, very good afternoon to you. This is Ruby Singh from MIT University, Haryana, Corporate Resource Center. Today's session is very beautiful and a very meaningful and helpful to you, since it caters to internships and what are the benefits of undertaking internships during your studies, how the internships are beneficial to you. So this is our first interaction with you all. I have my entire team from MIT University Corporate Resource Center, Haryana, with us, and our director, sir, Mr. Manoj Sahni, sir. Unfortunately, he's not able to join me because he's into some medical urgency. So I should be taking for you further with the session. As you very well know, how many of you are knowing there's a resource center? So Corporate Resource Center is there, very much present physically in gear you for internships, for your job offers. And we are one people along with your faculty who are able to take you further towards the corporate world, towards jobs, towards interaction with the outside world. So what is a Corporate Resource Center? The university industry engagement concept, you know, it is involved into strategic partnership between MIT University and the industry. So they are stakeholders who commit to, or they come forward and collaborate with us in the fields of career enhancement, research. There are industrial trainings. There's so many opportunities. These are all these activities, you know, which are beneficial to the students as well as to the industry. So the partnership implements ideas and concepts to meet the challenges. So it prepares you to meet all the outside challenges and the needs of your studies, because studies is what you learn while doing your bachelor's or master's. But when you go into internships or jobs, that is your practical application of what all you have studied. So internship is in the middle, you know. It is not when you are over with your studies. It is somewhere a bridge between your studies as well as your jobs, you know. So it helps you prepare for the final outcome. So let me introduce you to our beautiful team. We have Mr. Manoj Sahni, sir. He's director and head industry integration. So he's director for Corporate Resource Center as well as head for industry integration. Then we have Mr. Ankur Gupta, sir. He is deputy director. Then we have Rishi Raj, sir. He is AGM. Myself, I'm a senior manager here. And we have Mohammed Sohail, sir, and he's senior office assistant, who helps us with all the back-end operations. Now, let me make you understand what is Corporate Resource Center objectives, why we are there, and what is the purpose, how we can help you. So we are here to transform you by developing your skills, you know, for a particular job profile so that you are more employable. So we help you in that. We identify your skill gap and communicate the training and development plan of action with you. So there are many students who come forward and interact with us, and we are able to show them the career path. And also we are able to help the bridge the gap between the students and the recruiters by empowering them, by counseling them, and also creating opportunities for them, you know, and so that they can easily take part in all the hiring process which is going on, and they can avail all the market opportunities which are at that particular moment present in the market. So it's a healthy engagement with the corporate and the recruiters for a better value. Training and development, enhancing employability. So the focus for our Corporate Resource Center, why we are there to train and develop you so that you are readily employable. We help you engage with the corporate, with the best of the companies, the Fortune 500 companies, the top MNCs, and good brands. We offer you summer internships. As soon as the opportunity is there, we come forward and share the job notice, which many of you would see on Amazon. So I must tell you that once you are enter into the final year or from the summer onwards, you should assess your Amazon. And on the notices column, every day you will see so many job notices for different institutes coming up, whether it's an internship, whether it's a project, whether it's upskill upgradation or a workshop or a job notice. They're all there. Campus placements are there. Corporate guest lecture series. We very, very regularly do corporate guest lectures. Recently, we had a filmmaker, eminent filmmaker, Prasoon Sinaji. He was telling all about the process, the language of films. Then we have alumni engagements. So very rich alumni we have. And all the alumni feel very privileged to come forward and engage with you on many platforms which we arrange. So what is the process of communication to you? Many of you might be interested. So we are apprising you regarding the placement related activities through the following process. As I told you, Amazon, if you go to Amazon, there is a notice section where you see all notices. There are all job notices and internship notices featured there. Then also we email on your email ID, which you have provided to the placement cell through your department. Also through calls and SMS alerts. So all this data comes from your department to CRC, from which we have the members of CRC calling you for respective departments. Okay, and also sometimes the department helps us in reaching out to you. Beautiful word, internship, or you may call it apprenticeship. At young age, the focus is more on learning. You know, at your age, the more you learn, the more richer you are, you know, acquiring skills, knowledge. And many of the students, they think, oh no, the salary is too less. So the thought process has to move because you have just come out of the studies from the books, you know. And you have just no idea how this is applicable, what is what you have studied is how it's applicable in the real job scenario. So this is a learning stage. The more you learn, the better you earn. That is by a famous quote by Mr. N. Murthy, Narayan Murthy. Let's go through internship. What is internship? What mean? An internship is a temporary position with an emphasis. See, internship is a temporary position with an emphasis on the job training, run on employment. Okay? It can be paid or unpaid. Don't go by this ki paise nahi milenge. Learning is more important. So to intern, it means to pass inside something. The literal meaning of intern is to pass inside something. And when you have an internship, it's like you are temporarily gotten permission to be inside a workplace. What does internship do? An internship is a period of work experience offered by an employer to give students and graduates exposure to the working environment in their industry. Often with a specific industry, if it's a mechanical plant would be there. If it is a software thing, then of course office work will be there. So also this relates to their field of study, naturally. Internships can be short for a week or as long as 12 months. Okay. So how an internship will benefit you? Gain experience in your chosen field. Internships are a gateway to gain hands-on. So who is going to help you out? When you pass out, everybody is going to ask you, what did you gain? You need to have a practical exposure before you get a job. Internships is a venue where you can say, okay, I had an opportunity to get hands-on training during my internship on so-and-so project, so-and-so company. Okay, so this is a professional experience that will be valuable during the job search. So since you have no experience, you are very new starting your career. So this is one experience, one and the only experience. The more internships you do, the more better it is during your holidays or virtual mode, however. So you have to choose between what interests you and what matches your career goals and the degree course that you are doing. The major part of having an internship is learning more about the field as well as your personal strengths and weaknesses. You can upgrade yourself if you feel Excel is able to help you. Master Advanced Excel is going to help you in a particular field in your degree of ethics or in biotechnology or in engineering. Please go ahead, add that credit, add that skill to your resume. What is needed for an internship? Interesting. Organization require formal application, a resume, cover letter, transcripts, 2 or 3 letters of recommendation, as well as essay. So these are different companies asking for either all of them or many of these things. As to why they want to know why you're interested in interning with their particular company, what is the reason behind? And they'll ask you all the questions related to that in the interview or for the internship. So not all companies have the same requirements. Each company may be having a different requirement. What is the purpose of internship? The purpose of internship is to provide real world experience that enables you to put everything you have learned into action. An internship can help you gain skills that can be applied to future jobs. Internships may be paid or unpaid. Okay. And they tend to last about the length of a school or semester or a summer break. Just a second. So, is an internship a job? Many of you would say, oh, it is something similar to a job. Only thing is learning job. Okay. Many internships are paid positions while others are not. And non-paid internships offer valuable work experience that help enhance a resume. Whether paid or not paid, the work is still a form of employment. Now we come to, can an internship turn into a job? Many students are very, very keen. Many employers who offer internship do, see, they treat it as a window to come into an, they want to know the students, their future employees more. So this is a window to let you in. So you all know that you cannot come into an organization through a window. So window is a field. And this is an opportunity given to you to make a mark in that company through that project, through that small tenure of time that you're going to work for them, under whose guidance you're going to do, under that project that you're going to do. So that is your window to show your skills, your hard work, your knowledge, proactive interest, you know. Okay, so if you're interested in turning an internship into full-time job, you can use some specific techniques like these to increase your chances of getting hired. Why do we need internship? Internships provide you with building blocks. You need to, your future internship opportunities help you set the foundation for your career, you know. Many cases come to interns after graduation. It's not during studies only internships are there. Many a times you finish your degree, still the companies are interested in taking you as an intern because they want to know you more and more before they actually sign a track with you. Okay. Internships are an awesome way to improve as a job applicant and make you a better future employee. Now you see, there is a plethora of benefits that you can gain from an internship. Gain valuable work experience, explore a career path. You can give an edge in the job market. It's, see, many students, almost all students do internship. But how you do an internship? How much of your own send you to the internship, or you take virtually. So it is just like job. You have to, your mindset has to be, it is my window to get a job. So you need to put your more than 100% into the internship in every way, because they will be evaluating you, how you fit into that organization, by the knowledge that you bring to the organization, by the skill set that you bring, and what is your nature, malleable with others, or you don't want to mix up with anybody and you want to be a separate person. So there are so many qualities that you are getting checked on in during an internship. And then only every company, the way you introduce some new member into your family, and like in a marriage or other relationships. So similarly, a company is like marrying you, you know. So before marriage, they are just taking you through an internship. So network with professionals, and you get to get the confidence. There's a transition into a job. So all these are the benefits of an internship. So internship can be these days of a different type, virtual internship or on-site internship. So as you know, coronavirus epidemic is creating a havoc throughout the world. And again, it's on the rise. So many of the companies, they are offering virtual internships, and I think it is the best time of your life to avail these, because after your sessions, the college sessions, you can easily do some projects and earn that extra mileage. Virtual internship and on-site internship, there are a little bit of differences, or rather lots of differences, but the end result is the same. Stand to win. So virtual intern is the greatest chance to learn new skills and work professionally for a company. So both kinds of internships are equally important. You cannot be forever into a virtual mode. One day or the other, you have to be actually present in the organization. Have their own kinds of, because when you interact with the others, there's so many ways where you can create a bond with your colleagues, your bosses, when you are into a actual mode. Virtual mode, you can save time, you can be more available, and upskill yourself more easily. So virtual internship, if you categorically take out the differences, there's a lot of flexibility in the virtual internships, because you can sit anywhere in the world and work for a company or an organization. You don't have to commute from one place to another, as I told you. And availability of virtual internship is much more compared to the normal internship, because of the virtual internship, you don't have to limit yourself to a particular time. Many a times it is seen that, and they give you a time. Okay, you can do flexible. Little bit of flexibility is given to you as regards to timing, as regards to the location, Also, on-site internship, with normal internships, you are bound to sit in an office and field to deliver work. Advantage that is that you meet many people, as I told you, your colleagues, your bosses, you are able to create an impression, you are able to create a bond, you are able to do so. Different kinds of learnings in the office, and get to know different cultures along, because work is not limited only to work. Going for an internship, it is the whole organization. Everything impresses you, from the ambience to the way the employees are conducting themselves, the way the work is getting done, what is the decorum being maintained, There are so many other factors which impress you, and which the organization is looking at you from all these parameters. Okay, so with normal internships, you have less to save, because naturally it's costly to commute, and of course need to spend money. Of course, time limitation is from 9 to 5 or 9 to 6. So if we come to major differences, that virtual internships provide flexible working hours for intern, and one can do a virtual internship from any location that has an internet connection. It can avoid travel and daily commute. Both types of internship provide the same amount of knowledge and work experience, and both internships have supervisors to monitor the progress of the interns. if you look at closely at virtual internships, what is a virtual internship? Many of you will be thinking who are new and will be thinking, what is virtual internships? Why do we do it? Why should we do it? Just because Ruby ma'am said it, we have to do it? No. It is need of the hour. Because of the corona rising, there is very, very less opportunity. You have to really take help from the people, present faculty members, your HODs, and other stalwarts of the industry in your respective domain. You have to take help from them. I myself personally at this age also do interact with many people from different countries online and take their views and their inputs as to what they are doing in their life and how they are building up their career in that particular domain. Similarly, what kind of courses which we can do, what kind of certifications or skill set that we can develop. So all this is going to help you. Okay. So just to point out again, to gain work experience in a remote setting, online internship. So candidates are not physically present at the job site. So it helps you gain and develop skills in the particular sector. So it's also an opportunity to explore the industry or the role that might not be 100% committed to. So, okay, so you are not yet too sure. So this is also an opportunity to take an internship and get to know more and more about what exactly is the role all about. Okay, working from home reduces stress and increases happiness and productivity. So you are not no more stressed. Okay, so different types of stress are there, which we will take a separate session. Maybe that's a very big topic. But nevertheless, you are relieved of this kind of a stress. So definitely a benefit for organizations. So they can focus on the employees' health and well-being. If you are looking at an internship, how do you find it? And what are you applying to it? How are you applying to it? How are you finding an internship? Many virtual internships are existing. I don't need to tell you, you are very knowledgeable these days. So in the fields of IT, sales, journalism, marketing, biotechnology, stem cell, pharma, nursing, whichever be your career, jobs in these areas lend themselves to remote work, and you can find opportunities for virtual internships in other types of employment as well. Okay. Although the structure of the virtual internship may be different naturally than that of a traditional internship, the application process is normally the same. You will probably be asked to send a resume and a cover letter, perhaps some supporting material such as writing sample. And if a manager likes what they see in your application, you will be interviewed either by telephone or there may be multiple rounds, maybe a Google Meet or something like that. So before you accept any virtual internship, so there are so many things that you have to first clarify. Aisa nahi hona chahiye ki, I don't want you guys to regret later ki, oh, I hurriedly accepted an offer and now I feel I might not be able to justify it. I don't want that because it will create a wrong impression, both sides. So please go through it. What task will you be doing and what will be your responsibilities there? Will the training or supervision be offered only at the beginning or over the course of internship? You need to be very clear. How many hours per week are required for the internship? Is the internship paid? Can you receive college credit for the internship? Will you receive an evaluation or recommendation letter at the end of the internship? All these things you need to clarify from where you are doing the internship before you sign up for the internship. Will your supervisor be able to act as a work reference after the internship is over? Because many of them have their reservations. Many of them are very much helping and welcoming nature. So you need to clarify, could the internship lead full-time employment with the company? Many, many, 90% of the companies are looking for good candidates through internship. The trend is changing very soon. Many of the students are now finding so much happiness, I'm telling you, through internships. some of the online platforms where you, which can help you in taking up internships is Vegan, Intinshala, Akinon, Let's Intern, Oyster Collect, and many more. There are many, many more which are going on, doing rounds on the internet. You can please visit them and then filter through your particular stream and then find out what they have to offer. So there are some tips which I can take you through for successful learning experience. So when you meet your co-workers, as I was telling you, everybody's watching you. Not watching you in the literal sense, meaning they are aware that there's a new person and they are curious about you. So you need to introduce yourself to everyone in a particular department that you have joined, and you have the contact with each person. You know, you make sure you are into interacting with everyone. And so unless until you interact with them, how will you know what kind of work they are doing and how you can collaborate with them on which project? You might not want to work for your company past long term, but you will definitely want to get a recommendation from them. So whole idea is whatever time, whether it's a 1 month, 3 months, whatever is your duration of internship, the time that you are spending either virtually or in practical terms, so you make an impact, you make an impression by your good work and are able to, it's just normal, not a normal work, how you can excel in whatever job is given to you and make sure that reflects on your career. You are able to get a positive response from them, a recommendation, a PPO, that is pre-placement offer from them. So anything can happen so long as you're aligned. The better job you do, the more familiar your supervisor and other employees are with your personality and your work. Stronger will be your recommendation. Also, it's very important to set goals. It is always a good idea to meet with your supervisor at the beginning of the internship to find out what their expectations are. So this is, abhi tak to we were just discussing what is. Now we move towards what is going on in the mind of the supervisor. If your supervisor doesn't set a meeting with you, you should ask. Don't shy away. Ki kisi ne to pucha hi nahi. This should not be. You have to be proactive. You should ask for some time to meet. You should either virtually or practically, whichever is the situation, and you're expected to accomplish every day, every week. Ask them, what do you expect of me? Kya karna hai, kaise karna hai, what kind of technology, what kind of expectation that you have? You ask your supervisor. Make sure you request a feedback from your supervisor. You know, aisa nahi, because the supervisor is very, very busy. It is you who is needing it. So you need to make sure that you are visible to them by doing some projects and, you know, you get an opportunity to meet your supervisor regularly and take inputs. How to make things better, how to improve, how you can add by suggesting out-of-the-box ideas. Make sure you are on the right track. Finally, keep in mind that your own goals are for your internship and what you would like to learn. So you have to discuss your interest with your supervisor and ask if there are any opportunities to get involved in these areas. Now, there are more tips to make an internship successful as a learning experience. So many of the students I met earlier, they had not taken internship because of XYZ reason. Maybe the parents were shifting or they were shifting or they were distant or there was a financial problem, whatever. So what I would like to tell you is be prepared. This is very, very essential. This is 101% going to help you get a job. In your interview for the job, you are going to be asked only and only about what has been your input regarding the internship, what kind of project, what was the title of the project, what was the thought process, why did you do that project? What was it that you were looking? What is the step process that you followed to achieve to? And what was the conclusion? How satisfied were you? What if you have to make some changes, what kind of technology would you use? what can you change? What can you improve on that? So your mind has to be robust, you know. You have to be thinking very, very professionally. And your mind has to be always busy in a learning mode, you know. So watch and learn. This is what I would like to say. Understanding and acting in accordance with the culture of an organization is important. So there's a different people, route, different organization policies, procedures, meetings, and so on. You need to be professional. As I told you, you have to be mindful of how you present yourself to your co-workers and your supervisor. Yeah. What is your attire? How do you conduct yourself? Are you short-tempered? What are your personality aspects? What are your etiquettes? How do you handle challenges? If there's an X person irritating you for during the office hours and deliberately doing, what is your response? How do you handle such kind of a situation? So along with that, there are a few important things like emailing and addressing. There's a letter. So all these things you should know. How to professionally write a mail, a letter, and how to address an issue, how to write a problem or any situation. Okay? So these are very important because now you are almost a part of the company. So you aapko unke culture mein dhalna hai. If you spend 4 years in MIT, you become an MITian. So this is a window, an opportunity for you to also look into if you fit into that organization. Okay. You need to keep busy. If things are slow for you, make sure your supervisor knows. And then things are still slow, read some trade magazines or see if it's okay to ask other employee if they need help. Your helping nature can also be appreciated. See, one of the gestures which I can tell you where you make more friends is buying coffee for your contacts, you know. Over a tea time break or a lunch time break, you can bond more with them, other people, you know. Otherwise they are also busy in doing the office work. You will never get an opportunity. You can reflect on your experience, you know. There's no formal review in an internship, you know, but you have to ask your supervisor for feedback and of your performance, you know, in between. Don't wait for the end of the internship. In between, you can make things improve so much better if you take feedback. So there are a few do's and don'ts. Some internship do's. Now these are what I'm going to be a little bit what you should do during an internship. You do complete the internship during your college career. In fact, try to get multiple internships to give you a better idea of you might want to do or be as a career. Have a polished resume. Polished resume means which covers every aspect of your personality. Whatever is written there in your resume will be asked. You've written that it's your hobby to play cricket. You may be asked questions relating to what is the size of the cricket ball, what is the weight of it, what brand is available. If you're a classical singer, you may be asked questions relating to that. Are you able to get you? Because this is how they see whether you have just written for the sake of writing or you are professional. And if you're writing that you want a job, and similarly, during the course of your talks, you say that, okay, I'll do PhD. So you will be cornered on that. You need to be very clear what you want to do. They'll give job to only those who are keen for the. So you need to be very clear regarding this. Then how to write thank you emails. Even if you don't get your internship, try to make an impression. Write thank you emails or thank you notes.
and for their assistance, and also specific goals for your internship. Do exactly what you want to accomplish. Do you remember that you are in the professional setting? You will be treated as a professional. It is expected of you to behave professionally at all times. Very important, the role of a mentor within the internship organization. So from all the people that you meet, there is someone in that organization whom you meet who takes an instant liking to your working style. And he's a helping supervisor or anybody else, not necessarily a supervisor, could be anybody. So also you keep in your mind that it is your responsibility to leave your internship with new skills, accomplishments. Like, you cannot say, I went for an internship and these guys, they didn't even look after me. Nobody asked me, nobody taught me, we couldn't do anything, and that's it. You cannot put the blame on the organization alone. As I told you earlier, you have to be proactive. It is your responsibility to be proactive, to network with people, what they have learned, what you can learn, how much more you can learn. Okay, apart from the skills that they have shared, that these are the things that you will do. How you can think out of the box and contribute to the organization. So these are the positives that will add to your internship experience. To keep in touch with people who play a major role in your internship, even if the experience was not the best, they'll become part of your professional network later on. Okay, so please update your resume with accomplishments from your internship. Very important, your resume should be full of talking points that can be used for future interviews. As I told you, since this is the only experience that you have of the corporate or the away from your academics. Last but not the least, do enjoy your internships. At times you might feel that you're doing your grunt work, but keep it and your hard work will eventually pay off. So don't pass an opportunity to gain an experience beyond the official scope of internship. You should go. It's a good to be proactive and go above and beyond what is expected of you. Don't be shy. Don't be afraid to ask questions. Whatever is not clear, please seek clarity and do lots of work, lots of contribution under guidance. ऐसा नहीं है कि आप करते जा रहे हैं एंड यू मूविंग इन द रॉन्ग डायरेक्शन. प्लीज टेक गाइडेंस एंड बी स्मार्ट. डू नेटवर्किंग. फाइंड आउट हाउ थिंग्स आर डन इन दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड इन अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आल्सो. यू शुड बी अहेड ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. इफ यू इनटू अ टेक्निकल एप्लीकेशंस यू शुड बी नो. इफ यू आर इनटू नर्सिंग व्हाट आर द रूल्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. व्हाट इज फॉलोड इन दैट पर्टिकुलर हॉस्पिटल. ओके, सो ऑल दीस थिंग्स यू शुड बी नोइंग. व्हाट इज द इंटरनेशनल सिनेरियो. What kind of diseases are spreading? What is their ratio? What is the composition? How do you deal with them? What are the side effects? So all these things, you need to be very, very thorough. Don't forget to take advantage of all the benefits the internship has to offer. Okay? Don't ever give up on your quest to obtain internship. Mere ko to mila hi nahi. Many students, they come and tell me, hame to mila hi nahi. Humne to bahut jagah apply kiya tha. Something is amiss. Never, ever give up. Please try, use networking. How many portals are there? Please talk to your faculty. Please speak to CRC. Go to the website, MIT website. Check there daily. It is your duty. Don't ever give up on your quest. And even if your internship experience wasn't all that you wanted it to be, the contacts you made help you. Please be in touch with them. Expect all in. Why students every time want the experience, the internship experience to be a monetary benefit? You cannot. Many a times it's not possible for the company to, because they are already putting manpower to train you. They are moving their managers and senior people away from their job, and they are devoting time to train you. So already there's a cost earned from. So they cannot afford more cash to the students. So don't think that you have contributed, they have not contributed, they have equally contributed. And many a time you will see many job notice from CRC which are saying internship job notice. So that is a condition of the university for the corporate student based on the internship work. They are doing exceptionally well. We would actually student an opportunity. There's a company, and this student was doing history honors, but was fortunate to get through the internship of a different domain. So this is definitely going to add to her career. So similarly, you can also pick up upskill yourself in many ways. Don't get intimidated by other people. I was the odd one out, I was the only one asking questions. Don't intimidate. Some internships might be difficult to land as a job. It's not necessary that you do a very good exceptional internship so you don't get a job. So don't think into a negative. That means that you have done lots of hard work and you have uplifted your skill set. You have added more to your resume. Now this is all of you, I hope you can see very clearly. This is a sample resume. This is my CRC Institute and your faculty CRC coordinators. They all have this format. There's a logo MIT here. Resume, picture. So it has to be a very professional picture. Please do not put Facebook, LinkedIn, or any other casual photograph. It has to be professionally official with the hair properly done, not too bright, the lots of makeup, earring dangling and all, hair lying here and there. And please, the corporates do not appreciate this. Write your name, your university enrollment number, full, complete. Your course, your location, date of birth, email, contact number, LinkedIn ID. It is a very good idea to write your LinkedIn right here. Many companies look for recommendations because on your LinkedIn ID, there are so many recommendations that you have given or you've got from different people and which can be viewed by the companies. Here, one or two line of objective, very sensitive. Which has to find a fine map. So project on organic components. Suppose, for example, there's a project which you did and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what was the learning from that? Suppose there's a particular technology or a skill set or a language which you picked up from there, you can write there. Then industrial visits. For example, this lady here had gone to Minda Corporation. What was the learning there? They understood their supply chain, you know, visited their assembly line, so on. And Suzuki Cycle, they went, what did was the learning, 1, 2, 3, 4. Skills and certifications, what are the skill sets that Sunaina has? She was MS Office, intermediate level. Then she has completed a course in computers and received certification in CCC. She is excellent written and verbal communication and skilled in prioritizing management data. So she is original generally. Then academic admins and activities. So she is a winner of so-and-so competition, classical dance, inter-college even, and participated in university level Olympic sports and so on. So this is how you build your resume and you can add more to it. It is preferable that your resume is single page. So let's move further ahead. Now, did you know that the college graduates who held an internship or a job related to their future career were twice as likely to find a stable job immediately after college? So this is a source from Gallup, which says that all those students who had the opportunity of doing an internship are so much knowing about what is there outside the academic world or after their degree course, what is in store for them. So there are more chances, twice as likely to find a stable job. So students, that is all I have for today. And I suppose many of you would be having lots of questions to ask from you. Arvind sir, can you please unmute all the students and faculty so that they can ask questions one by one?
Ma'am, I can unmute one by one.
Students, can you raise your hands? Those who would like to ask questions or queries, you can raise your hands and I'll try to answer your queries. Hello, I have written in the chat box, is there any question or query? Okay, Anushka, I see you. Can you tell us about the companies best for pharmacy students? So there are many companies in pharmacy. So many of the pharmaceutical companies, we do invite them regularly to our campus as a guest, also for hiring also, and internships also. So few of them, Aurobindo Pharma is one where many students had gone. Auronex is a sister concern of Aurobindo Pharma. So many of the, they make dry injectables, they export them. So their R&D, they have visited many times. Then you have Sun Pharmacy, where many students do, but due to Corona, everything is on the hold. I had a talk with many of the pharmaceutical companies. And further, there are Arbro Pharma is there, and three, four more pharmaceutical companies who have shown interest for this current batch. Then virtual internship. Prateek, your question is, virtual internship is okay, but what about the lab-based internship? Because we cannot have exposure to lab equipment, which is necessity in biological sciences field. Lab-based internships are there, Prateek, and I had taken out a couple of job notices related to that. Now I'll tell you what, this internship, to get into internship into R&D lab, you need to qualify their interviews with the R&D head and the quality head. There's a panel. So there's a process, and each company, the more established brand it is, the more expectations they have. So there are many organizations, you can take the data from Sumishna ma'am, where students have earned their internships multiple times, you know, and they have won the job also. Ashutosh Rajan, ma'am, how can we make our resume attractive? See, there is nothing different you have to do. You have to follow this MIT University format only for writing your resume. Okay. So you have to make it more attractive by upskilling yourself. What courses you are doing, any skill set which you are doing. If suppose you are doing data analytics, so what kind of tools that you have learned, which are used in data analytics, what kind of virtuals you are doing, you can mention. Any session that you have attended, expert in your field, and what was the learning from the session. You can go ahead in that session and take contact details from that mentor of yours and make him your mentor or her your mentor, and be in touch with them. Ask them, whatever project they are doing, take you as an intern. Even if you do not know, but you will be learning so much by helping whatever task that they give you. Okay, Ashutosh. Then please guide for data student who is new to this field. So for data science students, I have only one request to you. You have to first study. Every student who is doing data science, actually data science requires lots of technical courses which you have to do in order to excel in data science. For example, Python is there, Ruby is there, and so many other languages there which you need to be upskilled. So I don't know whether you have, because last batch which I was addressing, very few students knew of the tool. So so many companies who are coming to our campus for analytical role. You know, data science and analytical roles are there for you, but and also for engineering students. Almost 99% of these opportunities require you with the set, which I think you need to upgrade your and do networking to find or network with the college students, those who have got it, those who have take for this, and how they are doing it. There's no harm. So, Rohan Phillips, now your question is how virtual internship is possible in how virtual internship is possible in nursing, because in nursing, see, I had done okay, so let me answer you. We had organized a workshop for the nursing students directly. The nursing head from VL Kapoor Hospital, she was in the lab and demonstrating in the workshop how things are done in that particular. The topic was what was the process in COVID for a pregnant woman, you know? I think that was the topic. I may be wrong also, but I think that was the topic. And she demonstrated how the processes and what all safety equipments has to, and what precautions has to be done, and what are the step-by-step thing to be followed, you know? That was also being told. Vijaykant, you need to connect with your mentor, your coordinator, course coordinator, and resolve this, because I think there is a gap there. And that doesn't necessarily mean they are not being taught, because no college is, it can exist without teaching. So there is a gap there which has to be resolved. Prashant Rohila, internship for MSc data science is offered by college. See, no internship is particularly offered to anyone. Almost all the colleges in all of the world, the students go to the industry, to the corporate, to the organizations, and find out which organization is best for them in terms of learning in the course that they have taken up. They get the companies to the campus. So that is how things are happening since ages. Internships by the university are also offered. So some of the organizations approach us for internship in a particular domain. So we put it on the notice board on the Amazon notice area. So you can check it from there and apply. So Vijay, I think you have an issue here that they will not consider it as summer internship. I think you can speak to your CRC coordinator, faculty coordinator, and they'll be able to guide you, or they'll able to contact CRC, whichever domain you are. So for engineering, I think we have Rishi sir, and Ankur sir is there for all management and related courses. And I'm taking care of medical and pharmaceutical and psychology and so on. So all such queries can be directed to me. Of course, nursing also I'm taking care of. So we do justification by sharing what all we can share, opportunities that we can share with you students. What about placements at the end of the year? Companies will be coming to campus. Now, anonymous attendee, I don't know who is the person. So it's better I know the name. Once I know the name, I'll be able to answer you better. Anushka Gupta, what are the questions they obviously ask us? I told you, Anushka, your resume, you have to put it in front of them and they will ask questions in the internship. For example, you yourself think you want to do internship in their company. They'll ask this question, why our company only? Suppose you are doing mounting an internship into a X domain. So you have to relate it with the course that you are doing. this internship with your company will benefit me my doing my course. I'll get a great knowledge course. I'll get a purview into what exactly goes, how things are done. I'm sure I have answered your question quickly. So that's all. I do not have any more questions. Any questions more if they are needed? Any more questions? Are there any more questions, sir?
No, ma'am.
Students, you can raise your hand. Students, if anybody has any more questions.
Yes, ma'am. I had a question, ma'am. Ma'am, like in one of my internships previously, the superior and I had a bit of a battle as like my manager as to how the work credit needs to be given. Like I used to do the work and then she used to take the credit. So then how does one deal with that?
Which department are you referring to?
Ma'am, I was in the marketing department.
Marketing department?
Yes, ma'am.
Can we take this separately? Because I need to understand in detail what is the situation like. You can call me anytime and we can discuss this and try to resolve it along in confidence with your department faculty coordinator, CRC coordinator.
Okay? Ma'am, no, this already happened previously. Not right. Like it happened to me previously. So like I finished that, but I wanted to know how does one deal with this? It's not present. It happened in the past.
Okay. So we will talk separately on this. I need to understand a little bit more details so in order to guide you properly better.
Okay.
Fair enough. So we have Muskan Gupta. Are there some links, companies with CRC for internships for data science? So now, Muskan, you all of you must be knowing ATPC site is also there. That is MIT Technical Placement site is also there. So they also take out few notices for internships. And for our university, ATPC notices are re-shared by Rishi Raj sir from CRC team. He takes care of engineering. Muskan? Are there some links to companies with CRC for internships? So all the links that you are there for internships, which are there on the notice board. Currently for data science, there are few opportunities which are open to the engineering students. If they are applicable to you, you need to be getting in touch with Rishi Raj sir from the CRC department. Please write to me. I'll further direct you for all such queries. Okay. Raksha Rathore, what about placements at the end of the year? Companies will be coming to campus. Who will let us know about the requirements for the company? Raksha, if you have seen my presentation, I had shared how CRC interacts with you guys, all the students, how they come to know about the opportunities. I told you there are different ways that CRC gets to share all the information from the companies which is available, whether it's internship or placements. All job notices or internship notices are displayed on Amazon in the notices section, which you have to check daily. Also, you need to connect to your respective CRC placement person so that they are able to help you. And one thing I want to make it very, very clear that CRC department is a helping hand to you. There is no you cannot, you know, it's not a right that, okay, you have to get placements, is it? We help you, we support you. What all opportunities are coming to the market, we help you bring to you through our connections with the corporate world. But at the same time, having said that, students mostly, because it is an expensive affair, students mostly, they spread out and they go to the related companies and find out what are the types of internships that will suit them. Because most of the internships either they are unpaid or the payment is little bit less on the lesser side, which does not meet your state, because many internships are far placed from India, especially in the manufacturing sector and especially in the R&D sector. So all the companies, they do not have R&D at every place. They have in India at a particular place where research-related internships can be held only on those labs. Depends particularly in which course you are doing. This is just an example. So many a times, students come forward to us, okay, this is what I want to do. Can you please help me connect with this company? So we try to do from our network of our companies, we try to connect and help the students with the same. And many a times there are opportunities. If you look through the past records, you will find that there were many companies which had come forward and interviewed our students. So those who cleared the interview levels from the panel, they got the opportunity. Many students could not clear the tough R&D round. So that's entirely, we leave it to the company, because we just can help you get to the company. And rest you have to manage. You have to prepare yourself. You will have to take the help of your faculty to groom yourself, upskill yourself related to the company, because each company is into a different aspect of your domain. For example, it is your pharmaceutical company. For example, so many of the pharmaceutical companies operate in a different, some are making dry injection capsules making, and so on. So different types of roles are there, different types of opportunities are there, and the core technical, many a times I have taken out many opportunities into the plants where the students are required to be there at the plants. Excel Dynamics was one which company where many of the students are doing internships, which is situated in Bhiwadi. So you cannot expect the company to be giving an opportunity just next to your house. Are you getting me? So be prepared. You should be open to moving out. And if this is the career that you want, you need to spread out and move and pick up the opportunity there. Aishman, how does one cope with battles with the superior over work? Aishman, you'll have to speak to me separately to understand what is this battle that you are talking, because this session is related to internships. So I feel this is quite away from the topic that we are discussing, Abhi. But nevertheless, you can speak to me separately. And if possible, I'll try to help you in whatever knowledge or experience I have. So I think, students, this has been a wonderful session. We have really mastered so much of an interaction that never was there because of this epidemic taking shape. But I'm happy that this has been a beautiful platform where all of us have come together and get to know each other. At least you know CRC department is there and they are doing their level best to bring to you opportunities which can possibly be there. And don't forget to check out your notices column for all the opportunities. That's all for today. I'm very thankful to the departments for taking out your time. And I'm thankful to all the students who have made this opportunity a good one, where we have interacted over internships and how they can benefit you. And I would really like all of you to come up and interact more through your placement coordinators, so that we can make this experience a more beneficial one. Thank you so much. That's all for today.